In a normal neurosurgical situation, the neurosurgeon determines sort of the operative plan based on preoperative images. But if we use the example of a brain tumor, we would define or decide based on images beforehand about where the tumor was and about how much tissue we think needs to come out. But during the operative procedure, as we begin to remove tissue, the brain, which is soft, will change its shape. It'll move according to how the tissues are removed, so that the preoperative information is very quickly no longer accurate. What an intraoperative MRI allows us to do is to define right in the middle of the surgical procedure, right when we need to know that information the most, what's tumor and what's not tumor. The intraoperative MR scanner itself moves into the operating room on an overhead railing, and it moves to surround the patient, and then we can obtain the information. But in this case, the patient's operative site is sterile, and so when we move the MR back out of the way, we can resume operating without delay. So the intraoperative MR scanner is an invaluable tool in looking after patients with neurological disorders. And we can do things that we really couldn't do before with it. But it is only one part of a much larger picture of looking after patients with neurological disorders at the University of Michigan. We have a wide team that involves neuro-oncologists, neuroradiologists, dedicated anesthesiologists, and nursing staff who are all experts in taking care of the very specific neurosurgical problems that we face. And functioning in that team environment is critical to our success.